I have a simple philosophy. To optimize a process, you have to be able to control it. But to control it, you first have to measure it. And this is true for the carbon-in-leach, or CIL, gold extraction process.
Carbon-in-leach accounts for about 75% of the world's gold production. In this process, ground gold-bearing ore is dissolved in a chemical slurry. Granules of activated carbon are added to absorb the dissolved gold before further processing. To optimise this process, you must precisely control the ratio of activated carbon to slurry. Simply put, too much carbon is inefficient, while too little allows dissolved gold to be lost to tailings. Currently, measuring the carbon to slurry ratio involves taking a small sample from the tank. It's time-consuming and has drawbacks in terms of frequency, accuracy, and repeatability. Curtin University's Gold Technology Group has designed and developed an automated carbon meter to continuously, reliably, and accurately measure carbon concentrations in CIL tanks. This robust, self-contained unit takes samples up to 20 times larger than the manual method every 15 minutes, 24 hours per day, which it feeds into a measurement cylinder that strains the larger carbon particles from the slurry before a laser beam accurately measures the amount of captured carbon. This data, along with the well-established SimSil modelling tool, is used to optimise carbon management to a degree not previously possible. The end result is less soluble gold lost to tailings. Gold producers are processing higher tonnages of lower grades of ore than ever before. And along with fluctuating gold prices and increased costs, optimising processes is the key to long-term profitability.
For many CIL operations, optimizations resulting in recovery of a hundredth of a gram more gold per tonne of slurry processed can increase annual revenue by millions of dollars. And this is a significant benefit for any mining operation.